Soho, the centre of London's cafe culture. OK, it's very continental, but a new report released today points out that it's not necessarily a good thing for those of us that find it hard to get around. The report, published by the Keep Britain Tidy campaign, backs up what wheelchair users and people pushing prams have been saying for years. That dirtier streets and all this street furniture are bringing down the quality of our lives. And there's the proof. All the filth and litter from the streets go onto my wheels and then onto my hands. So isn't it about time that we all started to clean things up? Mik Scarlet, BBC London News, going to wash his hands.
Poor old Mick.
Now for more on those stories, here's Mik Scarlet.
Thanks, John. Education Secretary David Blunkett today announced a complete restructuring of the primary school curriculum.
Mr. Blunkett is proposing new education goals and a teaching service strategy which will affect children throughout the English school system.
Charity worker Joe Ryko became an e-millionaire last night, but not through his stock valuation. He was the winner of Channel 4's e-millionaire show. Mr. Ryko now stands to benefit from £500,000 worth of investment in his new online service for disabled people. Blimey, that makes a difference, doesn't it? Stories featuring disabled people that treat us just like anyone else in the news. Positive language and upbeat images. It makes such a difference.
Mik Scarlet has the story.
All of us wheelchair users want to get off the beaten track from time to time, whether it's to visit a park, sit on a beach and get a nice tan, or to enjoy the lovely countryside. But conventional wheelchairs only really work well on normal road surfaces. So we're left with two choices. We can either spend a ton of money on a different chair for each different terrain, or we can plan our journeys to avoid cobblestones, gravel, grass, and muddy fields. Ugh. So, roll forward the Trekkinetic. Modern, sleek, daring and innovative, it looks great. But does it work? And was its designer wise to risk everything to bring it to the market? Firstly, let's try Alton Towers. Woo-hoo!
Lee Sullivan and Chris Baldwin are members of the European Coaster Club. Their love of roller coasters has taken them all over the country. So who better to ask about the ups and downs of being a disabled thrill seeker?
So, Chris, tell us, what are some of the problems you've encountered when coming to theme parks?
Well, the most obvious one, of course, would be steps, which a lot of places tend to be very keen on putting instead of ramps. And another one would be turnstiles, which tend to make life very awkward, obviously, getting in and out of places. But of course, if you come somewhere like this and they've got it all covered with ramps, access and no problems for the disabled at all, really.
Well, as I haven't got very good control of my legs, I think this ride might be a little bit harsh on the old knee joints. So I'm not going on it, and that's my excuse, and I'm sticking to it. Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen, that was great fun.
What are your feelings on the two parts, the towers or here?
Oh, the towers, yeah, definitely. All round better part. Better access for the disabled people in general. Better quality of rides.
Do you think I should take up roller coastering?
Only if you enjoy it, Mick. And as you know, I probably don't.
So perhaps something different for you, Mick.
Bungee jumping.
Give it a whirl, yes.
Crippled, handicapped, disabled, physically challenged, differently able. Words are all labels, so here I am in Leeds with me labels to find out what the word is on the street. So if you were going to describe me, which one of these would you use?
I wouldn't use that, physically challenged.
None?
No.
Okay.
No.
Disabled, everyone's used to that.
Yeah.
Everyone knows what it means. Sounds more politically right.
Yeah.
Handicapped. No, not particularly.
No.
Handicapped, no.
No?
No.
Disabled, yes, yes, I'd use that word.
Right.
Disabled, probably. Let's stick to disabled.
As far as going over the jump is concerned, I would say that's where I get the biggest sort of buzz.
The first time I went over it, the adrenaline was just so amazing. I couldn't believe it. I don't know if I can say it on TV, but it's better than sex, basically. You do definitely get a big buzz out of it.
Least your worries.
I can imagine that if you did it a few times and got so you could actually do it without going the whole way around, it'd be a great laugh.
It's about as better than sex as... No, it's not better than sex, not at all.